Hello, Aquarius souls. Welcome to your reading. I am so grateful that you are here. My name is Nikki, and I use my clairaudient and channeling abilities to help people find the magic within. If you're new here, welcome. I am excited and honored to be doing this reading for you today. For this week's series, I will be channeling messages from famous animals in TV and movies for each zodiac sign. I felt called to do this week's series because since my spiritual awakening, I have had some truly amazing experiences with animals and being able to communicate with them. And as we raise our vibration on the planet, this is increasing. Many lightworkers have telepathic abilities to communicate with animals in this way. And it really is leading to more unity and a very good reminder that there is no separation on the planet, that we are one. So if you have been experiencing increased communication with animals at this time, it is not a coincidence. So how this reading will work, I wrote down 12 different famous animals on 12 different slips of paper. So we will pull one from the little tin here, see what your famous animal is, get the message, and then I will be pulling in cards from four different decks to accompany the messages that your famous animal is bringing. So let's see which famous animal has a message for you, Aquarius. I also found this cute little ladybug paper, just to stay true to the theme. I didn't have any other animal paper, so ladybugs bring good luck. All right, we have Brian from Family Guy. Okay, Aquarius, if you're familiar with Brian from Family Guy, he is the dog in that animated series, and he's very intelligent. He communicates very eloquently. He gets infuriated with his owners, though, and he does resort to drinking when he feels like he's being challenged a lot. But he also is a brilliant writer. So let's get some additional messages from your cards and see what else Spirit is bringing through Brian from Family Guy. The first deck of cards that we are using is the Labyrinth Tarot deck. Thank you, Spirit. What are your additional messages for my Aquarius souls? We have the Seven of Wands. Oh, I'm sorry, the Eight of Wands. Next, we have the Light Seer's Tarot. Thank you, Spirit. What else? We have the King of Cups in reverse. Next, we have the Super Attractor deck. Thank you, Spirit. What else? To begin the practice of allowing, I must get out of the way and let Spirit give me direction. And your final message will come from the Power Affirmation deck. Thank you, Spirit. What are your final messages for my Aquarius souls? I am worth loving. I do not have to earn love. I am lovable because I exist. Others reflect the love I have for myself. Okay, Aquarius. So your message from Brian from Family Guy with your cards, I'm being shown how he resorts to things that are outside of himself when his emotions get the best of him, because we have the King of Cups in reverse, and when this king is upright, he is very emotionally available and also emotionally secure within himself. So I feel on an energetic level that there are some wounds that your masculine side has experienced, and Spirit is suggesting that you take a look at what those are and allow yourself to feel them. Because like Brian has a very intelligent mind. He is a brilliant writer, but when he feels like there are challenges, or he feels like he's rejected, or he feels like he can't get through to his owners, he resorts to drinking alcohol and substances and things outside of himself that help to suppress his emotions. And Spirit is saying the key to not feeling those emotions is to not suppress them by actually allowing yourself to feel them. So the key is not to not feel them. The key is to honor your pain, to let it move through you. And I'm seeing that these emotions are stemming from a wounded masculine side. So it would be beneficial to balance both masculine and feminine energies within you so that polarity can bring balance within yourself. Because this card is right next to the Eight of Wands, things will start to move much more quickly and get into a flow state once you allow yourself to look at what these emotions are and allow yourself to feel them. Because your spirit team is giving you guidance on this right now. But they're saying to begin the practice of allowing, you must get out of the way and let Spirit give you direction. So if there are substances that are involved here, those are getting in the way of your intuition and what Spirit is trying to bring through. Now, that's not to say to 100% give up those things, but if you are looking for guidance from the spiritual realm or guidance that stems deep within yourself, substances block that. Or looking for validation outside of yourself will block that. It's time to go more within. And also journaling, because Brian is a writer. So writing out your emotions will help you to release them. You'll also get clear on maybe what some of these masculine wounds are so that you can do a deeper dive on them. But one of the biggest wounds I'm seeing here with the masculine energy was not feeling worthy, not feeling good enough, because we have, I am worth loving. And you are, Aquarius. You have always been worth loving, simply because you exist. You do not have to earn love. You are lovable because you exist. And others reflect the love you have for yourself. So every time you do receive a compliment from somebody, what that is that is a reflection of the inner love you're having for yourself. This is someone reflecting to you your self-love, because everybody in our experience is a reflection of us in some way. So when you're receiving love from other people, that is a reflection of the love you're having for yourself. I'd like to open up my clairaudience and get a little more information about this masculine wound, and also how you can begin the practice of allowing by getting out of the way to let Spirit give you direction. Thank you, Spirit. What other messages are you bringing through for my Aquarius souls? Yeah, I'm hearing wisdom. Spirit wants you to remember how wise you are. I'm being shown all of these examples of times where you have shared your inner wisdom from past lives, I'm even seeing, to help other people. Your wisdom, you have been adding value and being of service to people your whole life. You have been the answer to some people's prayers. You have been the person that has shown up with a bit of wisdom that helps someone in their time of need. I'm even seeing that this has been with strangers, like random people you have met on the street or in a store or anywhere. You showed up with a knowledge of wisdom that they needed to hear in that moment. So you have been helping people. You have been showing up by being uniquely who you are. And you are worth loving, Aquarius. You are good enough. You are valuable. You are amazing. Keep sharing your inner wisdom. You have a lot of it that would create massive ripple effects in the world. So whatever you're doing to bring this knowledge into the world in your unique way, it's really going to change the course of how things are done on planet Earth. And this wisdom, there's even more wisdom that wants to come through, but you have to get in touch with your emotions, specifically on the masculine side of your energy. Where is this wounding coming from? What created this? How can you allow yourself to feel these emotions and let them go? One big way is journaling, because Brian is a writer. What else, Spirit? Thank you. There's also, for some of you, certain foods that you're eating. I'm being called to tell you this right now. I am being called to let go of sugar in a very big way. And this has been very difficult because I love sugar. But I've been having these dreams where, okay, this is morbid, but I'm bringing this message through because we're a collective and we're doing this together, okay? But I had a dream where I was walking past this cemetery and there were people like half buried in the dirt, and there were people going around and they had baskets on their heads and Hershey bars and chocolate bars were being put in the basket. So my guides were telling me that if I don't let go of sugar, that it would be detrimental to my health. So I have opted for a lot of sugar-free things right now, things that will help to curb that craving while still getting the sweetness, but not consuming the sugar. And I've been finding a lot of really cool recipes on Instagram. A lot of people who do Weight Watchers, they share some really amazing recipes. So I highly recommend going on Instagram and looking up some recipes. I do this to help with my meal prep with me and my partner. We have so much fun creating lists every week to figure out what we're going to eat. And then we create a grocery list and go get the stuff. And I have so much fun cooking for us every week. And sometimes he'll cook too. We take turns. But it's been a lot of fun getting new recipes in that way. So another thing that's coming through here is to be mindful of what you're eating. If your guides have been giving you guidance like they've been giving me guidance in that way, that's not a coincidence. It's important to listen to that, okay? That doesn't mean that you have to 100% also get rid of sugar completely. You can have treats every now and then, but if you're getting those messages strong and clear, then it's time to listen to those. And I'm right there with you. I know. I get it. But Spirit wants you to know that you are worth loving, that you don't have to earn love. You're lovable because you exist. When someone compliments you, that is a reflection of your self-love. To listen to the direction that Spirit is giving to you right now, get out of your own way to get into a flow state and allow things to come to you. Assess what those wounds are with your masculine side and do some shadow work around those. Allow yourself to feel, to heal, and to thrive, Aquarius, because there are amazing things coming in right now with the Eight of Wands in a very fast-paced energy. There's just a few things to assess right now, and Brian from Family Guy is bringing the message of writing out your feelings to assess what certain foods or substances may be blocking your intuition at this time or may not giving you the energy that you need to show up in the world in the way that you would like, and also to remember how intelligent you are, that you have the universal DNA encoded within you. So you have that at your fingertips to tap into anytime you want, Aquarius. That is all that I am seeing. Those are your messages. If your reading resonated, if you enjoyed it, please be sure to like, subscribe, comment down below, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.